This week on Mgahawa.
After threats of a no confidence vote in parliament against President Kikwete's government, following that, there was a central committee meeting of Chama Chama Pinduzi, which apparently discussed all those issues. And now, finally, we have a new cabinet. Is this the kind of change that we can believe in, Semkae?
Well, I think it's the right move towards the change that we can believe in. Previously, Controller and Auditor General reports used to come out the same way as they do now. They'd upset parliamentarians because they, revealed acts of embezzlement and lack of...
Allegedly.
Wasn't satisfactory performance by government in the way it executes the budget. This would make parliamentarians very angry. They would huff and puff in parliament, but thereafter, nothing would happen. So I think this time round, parliament has shown its clout as an oversight body, and personally, I'm impressed that it's led to great accountability.
You're a media guy like myself. We pay attention to how the media tends to sort of cover some of these big stories. What was your impression of how the media approached this change in the cabinet?
Well, you see, the thing is, I would say that the number of publications that I read that talked about it all sort of sounded the same. As a matter of fact, it was not till I got online and then read on some site from, I think, South Africa or something that talked about Tanzania's cabinet reshuffling, that they went into why the certain individuals, they got rid of the various ministers, yeah. But then there's one weekly publication, a personal favorite of mine that I read.
You can name names.
Yeah, I know.
Please.
Raya Mwema, it's called.
Okay.
I personally enjoy taking time to read it, and even I thought they would go deep into the whole thing. Okay, yes, they went into the report, but they didn't really.
You're
still felt
to the CAG
wanting.
Report.
Yeah,
right.
Like the report and what caused these guys to lose their jobs, right?
Right.
I still felt like there wasn't enough, so I'm hoping that this week when I get to read it, because they usually cover the issues that I feel other media outlets have not been able to write
to
about.
Write about. A lack of depth in the media's coverage of this story. Do you accept that?
Yeah, I think it was a missed opportunity, like many other opportunities in the past have gone missing. And I think the reason is, probably attribute two reasons. One, commercial pressures of newspapers make them, compel them to focus mostly on personalities and the sensational stuff. So, they don't necessarily link it with the analytical. I think that's really important. But as well, I think the other reason is a capacity issue. And it's not, common to have journalists in our country who are well-versed on the, public finance management issues. These are skills you either build through time, through experience, or concerted effort in reporting in the same kind of thing, year in, year out, or through specialized training.
So the issue of transparency, Gaure, that's as you just alluded to just now, Semkae. This organization, has been working on issues of accountability with the executive and the parliament and so on. But then, at least in the allegations that are contained in that report, is that they are not as transparent as perhaps they should be. And that perhaps, I put it to you, is often what you see with a lot of NGOs and CSOs. Like the people out there who aren't actually aware of what these organizations are doing, aren't particularly aware of what goes on beyond what it is that they say that they're doing. Do you see that criticism as justified?
I'm going to play devil's advocate here.
Okay.
And say that it, in a way, it's none of our business. If they are doing something, for example, let's use LHRC, for example, because there was that case of WWF, World Wildlife Fund.
Right.
So there was this Norwegian funding that completely disappeared because of embezzlement again.
Yeah, because of some alleged embezzlement, yes.
Now with LHRC, as Semkae said, like, this was from way back, but then it suddenly appears when various events come along. For example, like, I'm not going to say that this is exactly what happened, but there was a doctor strike. Then one of the people who came, one of the groups that came up real strong was the LHRC, right? And along with other individuals and other organizations. And they made it look like the Prime Minister wasn't doing their job, right?
Okay.
I mean, I'm not...
I'm going to interrupt you there. I mean...
Catch Mgahawa every Sunday at 1:30 p.m. Mgahawa, globally local.